A very good evening, sisters and brothers. And welcome to our Eucharistic celebration as we gather today to give thanks to God for the week that has been and the week that will be. As the song says, all are welcome to this table of plenty. We hold in our hearts not just our prayers, but also those who have asked us to pray with them and for them. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Sisters and brothers, in today's Gospel we hear of Martha and Mary and their love for Jesus. For the times we have not loved God and others as we should, we ask God for pardon and forgiveness. Lord Jesus, you are the master teacher. Christ Jesus, you call us to friendship with you. Lord Jesus, you forgive us in your infinite love. Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you.
Let us pray. Show favor, O Lord, to your servants, and mercifully increase the gifts of your grace, that made fervent in hope, faith, and charity, they may be ever watchful in keeping your commands. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Genesis. The Lord appeared to Abraham at the oak of Mamre while he was sitting by the entrance of the tent during the hottest part of the day. He looked up, and there he saw three men standing near him. As soon as he saw them, he ran from the entrance of the tent to meet them and bowed to the ground. "My Lord," he said, "I beg you, if I find favor with you, kindly do not pass your servant by. A little water shall be brought. You shall wash your feet and lie down under the tree. Let me fetch a little bread, and you shall refresh yourselves before going further. That is why you have come in your servant's direction." They replied, "Do as you say." Abraham hastened to the tent to find Sarah. "Hurry," he said, "knead 3 bushels of flour and make loaves." Then running to the kettle, Abraham took a fine and tender calf and gave it to the servant, who hurried to prepare it. Then taking cream, milk, and the calf he had prepared, he laid all before them, and they ate while he remained standing near them under the tree. "Where is your wife Sarah?" they asked him. "She is in the tent," he replied. Then his guest said, "I shall visit you again next year without fail, and your wife will then have a son." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
He who does justice will of the Lord.
He who does justice will live in the presence of the Lord.
One who walks blamelessly and does justice, who thinks the truth in his heart, and slanders not with his tongue. Who harms not his fellow man, nor takes up a reproach against his neighbor, by whom the reprobate is despised, while he honors those who fear the Lord. Not his money at usury, and accepts no bribe against the innocent. One who does these things shall never be disturbed.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Colossians. It makes me happy to suffer for you, as I am suffering now, and in my body to do what I can to make up all that has still to be undergone by Christ for the sake of his body, the church. I became the servant of the church when God made me responsible for delivering God's message to you, the message which was a mystery hidden for generations and centuries and has now been revealed to his saints. It was God's purpose to reveal it to them and to show all the rich glory of this mystery to pagans. The mystery is Christ among you, your hope of glory. This is the Christ we proclaim. This is the wisdom in which we thoroughly train everyone and instruct everyone to make them all perfect in Christ. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, alleluia. Blessed are they who have kept the word with a generous heart and yield a harvest through perseverance.
Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus came to a village, and a woman named Martha welcomed him into her house. She had a sister called Mary, who sat down at the Lord's feet and listened to him speaking. Now Martha, who was distracted with all the serving, said, Lord, do you not care that my sister is leaving me to do the serving all by myself? Please tell her to help me. But the Lord answered, Martha, Martha, he said, you worry and fret about so many things, and yet few are needed. Indeed, only one. It is Mary who has chosen the better part. It is not to be taken from her. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
It is very clear that all our readings today touches on the theme of hospitality. We hear in the first reading, Abraham going all out of his way to serve the three guests. Paul speaks about being that servant of the church of Christ. And the all-famous gospel story of Martha and Mary. However, there is something deeper about this idea of hospitality that as Christians, we are called to imitate and to live. And that is, both the motivation and the manner in which we serve must come not from an obligation, but from a response to an experience and an encounter of God's love. And also, not from a desire for self-promotion and attention, but from the desire to glorify God. And I believe, sisters and brothers, this is what makes Christian hospitality different. This is what makes for authentic and effective hospitality. Or to use the words of Jesus in today's gospel, the better part. And so how do we constantly strive for this authentic, this effective form of hospitality, this better part? For a start, we look at our readings, and that is to first look beyond oneself. When we do so, sisters and brothers, we build rather than we break relationships. For if we only focus on ourselves, such as today's individualistic culture, we will not find time to see or even notice God right before our eyes. We see an example of this contrast between Abraham and Martha. In the first reading, despite being the hottest part of the day, the scripture says, Abraham looked beyond his own discomfort and inconvenience, and therefore in that doing so, was able to recognize God in these three guests. Martha, on the other hand, seemed to have focused on what she was doing, on herself, and therefore prevented her from recognizing God right before her eyes. How often have we been also too preoccupied with our own wants, our own problems, our own comforts and convenience, that because of that, we neglect and fail to see God right before our very eyes. Second, we are called to be attentive to the needs of others. And this is authentic and effective hospitality because it restores the dignity of the other. It makes one feel human rather than merely feel like a handout recipient. In today's highly materialistic culture, we tend to focus on giving material things, such as just donations, which is not a bad thing, but we overemphasize on that giving that we do not recognize or focus on the need to build that relationship to who we are even reaching out to, such as spending time with the other, being present with the other. And because of this, we often find ourselves consciously or unconsciously imposing ourselves, imposing our ideas, imposing our opinions upon others, rather than truly making time to listen and to understand who are we serving, what do they really need, and where they may be at this moment in their life. Again, we see an example of this through Martha's words to the Lord. When she says, Lord, do you not care that my sister is leaving me to do the serving all by myself? Again, was she attentive to what the Lord really was seeking when he was in their presence? Or was she only focusing on what she wanted to do, what she wanted to give, what she felt was right as the host? And finally, we are called to be self-sacrificing like Christ, who gave himself on the cross for our sake. This may sound like a given, but what we often don't realize, sisters and brothers, is that we tend to give what is of excess, what's comfortable, and what's convenient to us. This is neither authentic nor effective hospitality because the focus is on the me, myself, and I, not on the brother or the sister that we are serving to. And again, it's focused on our terms and not on the needs of the other. Being self-sacrificing is authentic and effective because doing so builds the kingdom in the here and now. And so, dear sisters and brothers, let us today and always strive to be like Abraham and Mary before we can serve like Martha. And that is to constantly look beyond of ourselves, constantly be attentive to the needs of the other, and to be self-sacrificing like Christ, so that we build relationships, not break them. We restore the dignity of the one that we serve, and we expand the kingdom of God in the here and now. This, sisters and brothers, is why the Lord calls this the better part. In response to God's word, let us now rise and together profess our faith in this God who calls us. Together, I believe in one God,
Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Mindful of the great kindness of God the Father, we ask him in faith and in confidence to incline his ear to our petitions.
Our response is, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That Pope Francis and all bishops and priests will proclaim Christ and teach the gospel with all wisdom and charity. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That Christ guides the minds and hearts of all civic leaders to promote peaceful resolution to all conflicts between nations. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our parish community will grow in faith by committing ourselves to the truth of the gospel with zeal, self-sacrifice, compassion, friendship, and hope. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Lord will stay close to the poor, the sick, the lonely, the hurt, and the dying, and comfort those in pain and those who are grieving. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Loving and gracious Father, guide us in the right paths and give us courage and strength to face the challenges of life. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Pray, sisters and brothers, and my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
O God, who in the one perfect sacrifice brought to completion varied offerings of the law, accept, we pray, this sacrifice from your faithful servants and make it holy as you bless the gifts of Abel, so that what each has offered to the honor of your majesty may benefit the salvation of all. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father of mercies and faithful God. For you have given us Jesus Christ, your Son, as our Lord and Redeemer. He always showed compassion for children and for the poor, for the sick and for sinners, and he became a neighbor to the oppressed and the afflicted. By word and deed he announced to the world that you are our Father, and that you care for all your sons and daughters. And so, with all the angels and saints, we exalt and bless your name and sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Heaven and earth are full.
You are indeed holy and to be glorified, O God, who love the human race and who always walk with us on the journey of life. Blessed indeed is your Son present in our midst when we are gathered by his love, and when as once for the disciples, so now for us, he opens the scriptures and breaks the bread. Therefore, Father most merciful, we ask that you send forth your Holy Spirit to sanctify these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, on the night of the Last Supper, he took bread and said the blessing, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, gave you thanks, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, Holy Father, as we celebrate the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Savior, whom you led through his passion and death on the cross to the glory of the resurrection, and whom you have seated at your right hand, we proclaim the work of your love until he comes again, and we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of blessing. Look with favor on the oblation of your church, in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us, and grant that by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now and until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion. Bring your church, O Lord, to perfect faith and charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and William, our Bishop, with all bishops, priests, and deacons, and the entire people you have made your own. Open our eyes to the needs of our brothers and sisters, inspire in us words and actions to comfort those who labor and are burdened. Make us serve them truly after the example of Christ and at his command. And may your church stand as a living witness to truth and freedom, to peace and justice, that all people may be raised up to a new hope. Remember our sisters and brothers who have fallen asleep in the peace of your Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection give them the fullness of life. Grant also to us, when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever. There in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles and martyrs, with Saints Francis and Claire of Assisi, and with all the saints, we shall praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ, your Son. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Lord,
deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
My Jesus, I believe you are really here in the Blessed Sacrament. I love you more than anything in the world, and I hunger to receive you. But since I cannot receive communion at this time, feed my soul at least spiritually. I unite myself to you now, as I do when I actually receive you in Holy Communion. Amen.
Let us pray. Graciously be present to your people, we pray, O Lord, and lead those you have imbued with heavenly mysteries to pass from former ways to newness of life. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Have a blessed week, sisters and brothers, and may we continue to be hospitable, not in the worldly sense, but in our Christian understanding. Be like Christ, huh? To look beyond of ourselves, to be attentive, and to build one another, so that to be self-sacrificing, so that, as the song says, through the works that we do, they come to glorify God. Thank you for your prayers the last weeks. You know, the brothers have been away for our assembly. Thank you for your prayers, and now we are back. And continue to keep us in prayer as much as we pray for all of you, that the Lord may continue to guide us on how to serve all of you effectively and authentically also in the coming months, especially as we come to the chapter in October for our new posting. So continue to pray that the Lord's Spirit continue to know what's best for all of us. Have a blessed week.
Spirit of God, fill us with fire to shine your light for all those in need. Give us the strength to love in your name, so all the world will come to believe. May your kingdom come, that justice may reign. May your kingdom come, that justice may reign. May our lives bear witness to the power of your name. May your kingdom come, that justice may reign. Giver of life, send out your spirit. Anoint your people that we might be healed. Send us with joy to the weak and the lowly, and let our love be your love revealed. May your kingdom come, that justice may reign. May your kingdom come, that justice may reign. May our lives bear witness to the power of your name. May your kingdom come, that justice may reign. We will go out proclaiming the kingdom. We will go out with mercy for all. We will go out and serve with abandon, with courage now to answer the call. May your kingdom come, that justice may reign. May your kingdom come, that justice may reign. May our lives bear witness to the power of your name. May your kingdom come, that justice may reign. May your kingdom come, that justice may reign. May your kingdom come, that justice may reign. May our lives bear witness to the power of your name. May your kingdom come, that justice will reign. May your kingdom come, that justice may reign.